Bismillah, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So I am Fauzan Muhammad and I will be the host for today motivation show, and we will have three speakers from 10th grade. Let's just call the first speaker Valdimir Malik Irawan.
Oke, okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, let's thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us the mercies and blessing so that we can attend in this beautiful place without any trouble and obstacle. Secondly, my salawat and salam always be given to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who has guided us from the darkness to the lightness. Okay, today I want to speak and bring the topic about concern for the environment. And why I'm bring this topic? Because there are many people in Indonesia not care to the environment. And so in this speech, I want to give some like little tips, maybe three tips. To care to the environment. At the first, what is concern for the environment? Concern for the environment is a possible predictor of the buying eco-friendly product. So this concern we must apply in our daily life to create clean. So because not just human in this earth on this place, because many living things in our environment like animal or other. Okay, now I want to give like three tips about concern for the environment. At the first, there is this place of dress in its place. So this is the easiest way to care to our environment, because we just dress our, maybe after eat we just dress in dress place, and so that little thing can help to our environment, make clean our environment. And the second is make schedule and work together to clean our environment. Make schedule, maybe we already do in EDN, because in EDN, there is picket schedule in class or in our room. So it's some way to clean our environment too. And the work together is we already do too. In every Friday, we always forced to clean our environment in EDN. And the last tips, there is clean the gutters to keep the channel smooth. If we know in internet, some people clean the river. In many places in Indonesia, because in Indonesia many river or gutters is not clean, so we must care to our environment, maybe like gutters or other, to make clean our environment. Maybe that's all can I give to my tips in these topics. Thank you so much to listening my speech. Sorry if I have some mistake. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you Malik for the speech. And now we will move on to the second speaker. That is Damar. You may come forward and deliver your speech.
Okay, Bismillah, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So firstly, let's thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us some message and blessing so that we can attend in this beautiful mosque with any trouble and obstacle. Secondly, may salawat and salam always been given to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has been with us from the Jahiliyah era to the Islamic era and from the darkness to the lightness. So the third, let's thanks to the host who has given me time to standing in front of you all so that I can giving some speech under title ways to focus on the class. So before we start to the main topic, I will introduce myself first. So my name is Muhammad Damar Pandia, you can call me Damar, and I'm from XKG. So many people when the class is starting or the lesson is starting, they will usually stay bored or open the other tab to make him interested. So that will make him not following the lesson and will make him not get a new skill. So if he not open the other tab or boring like that, he can make some like certificate or doing some course. So because of that, now I will give you some way to focus on your class. So firstly, remember what the reason you study in the class. So this thing will be motivated you in the class. So because of that, you can have some spirit to in the class to do something better, and because of that, it will be easier in the internship later. Secondly, maybe you can make some target so that you will be never be bored. Because if you bored, you usually think, what should I do next? Because I'm already bored. So because of this point, making a target, you can have some target that you can achieve, and maybe it will be a useful target that can make impact for other too. Or maybe you can do some course, achieve some achievement and other. So the third, that is have enough sleep. This thing is for people who usually when they're bored, they will be sleepy, and when they're sleepy, they will be sleep in the class and not following the lesson. For the lesson, maybe is like a useful lesson, but you will sleep is will be make your skill not up. So because of that, you will be get chased by other skill, and you will be cannot be solve the problem with yourself. So the last, maybe the fourth one is making interest note. Maybe this point is for the lesson that not use laptop, maybe like Dunia or other, for like you have to write down the lesson, the material. So this will make you interest in the lesson and not will be make you sleep. Is to make a interest note. Like you maybe drawing something like mountain and other, but not drawing a human or other. This will make you joy and have fun in the class. Okay, maybe that's all from me. Thanks you all for listening my speech. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you Damar for the speech, and now we will go to the last speaker, which is Nizar. Where is Nizar? Okay, you may deliver your speech.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nizar, I'm from TNDGB, and here I want to repeat my speech because in the past day I was failed to deliver my speech. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa bihi nasta'in ala umuri dunya waddin wa salatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursalin sayyidina wa mawlana Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. First of all, let's pray into our God. Let's pray and thanks into our God, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, who has been giving us some mercies and blessings, so that we can attend in this place with good condition and happy situation. Secondly, maybe since salvation always be given into our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who has been led us from the darkness to the brightness, from the Jahiliya era to Islamiya era. Thirdly, I want to say thanks to the MC who has been giving me time to speak in front of you all under the title Never Give Up on Your Dreams. I know you all have big dreams that you want to reach. Maybe you have the dream like have an exclusive car or a beautiful wife. And if you have the dreams or you want to reach, boldly you go of the direction on your dreams. Reach, catch your dreams. Catch until you reach your dreams. And when you feel down or unmotivated, just find the reason that can make you back up and rise again. Like something, dua or read Quran or something can make you fun and rise again. And do hard work to reach your dream and success. You always remember the thing that can make you fail on your when you reach your dreams is just you give up. And when you give up, and when you fail on your hard work, don't give up and be more intelligent. And maybe that's all from me. Oh yeah, if there are any mistake was from me, I'm so sorry. And إِذَا وَجَدْتُمْ كَلِمَةً صَحِيحَةً هَذَا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا وَجَدْتُمْ كَلِمَةً خَاطِئَةً هَذَا مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ هَذَا مِنِّي وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.
Okay, thank you, Nizar, for the speech, and that's all for the three speakers. And don't forget, tomorrow there are two speakers. The first, Brother Ahmad Dimas, and the second is Desta.